Hi guys, how are you doing? I hope you're doing well. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me again, your girl Kamis. Please, if you've not subscribed to my channel, kindly hit that button here and also turn on the notification bell so you'll be the first one to be notified anytime I upload a video. So you guys, I just want to talk about living illegally in Sweden. How do illegal immigrants survive in Sweden? Guys, remember that the other day I was talking about this young lady from Congo who was deported after living 11 years in Sweden. Remember, her name is Chan Selvie Lelo, and she came with her father and her daughter 11 years ago, and they seek for asylum, but it was rejected, and the decision was that they have to go back to Congo. But you know, sometimes if you get a negative decision, if they think, which most of the times they think you will obey to the decision or you will go back, then they don't have to put you in custody. So, but if they feel that this person might not eventually go back, then they might, you know, deport you immediately. Like, they will actually take you, detain you, or just buy the next available ticket and deport you back to your country. So this now this topic of this young lady made me to think, okay, this is a topic I think I need to talk about. So you guys, it's not news, it's not even anything new that we have so many illegal people living in Sweden. Not only in Sweden, in fact I don't even think Sweden has as many illegal immigrants than compared to other countries, you know, like the UK, you know, US. I mean, people are illegal everywhere, and as a foreigner, I don't blame them, because I understand that, guys, life is hard, earth is hard, and for somebody to go looking for greener pasture, it's not because he really wants to. Some people are pushed, maybe the situation back home, the environment where you came from, the life there is not as you know, sometimes it's not even like the actually many people is because of search of money, greener pasture, so that they will be able to support the people back home. And now after you have traveled miles and then you are told to go back to where you came from, it's a very tough decision. So you guys, I just why I had so many questions about Chancel Vielel, or let me just call her Lelo, because that her name is very difficult, that Congolese lady. Why I had so many questions was like, what really happened for her to be in the detention camp? Okay, remember, she came with her dad and her sister, and they got decision 2011. And another one came in 2007, okay, and still talking about the same thing, that they have to go back to Congo where they came from. So this girl, 2011, she was just 11, so she was not a teenage. So for 7 years she has been going to school until she's 18. That's what I want to just make like a calculation. So, and nobody ever arrested her or asked any questions. So one thing about Sweden is that they don't bother you. As long as you are doing what you're supposed to do, you are minding your own business, nobody is going to bother you. So I mean, nobody bothered her, but now she's 22, she graduated, and all of a sudden she was detained for, she was in the detention camp for 4 months. So I have been having so many questions, and I was like, oh, how I wish, I really want to know, why was she in the detention camp? What really happened? Did they come to her house and take her, or had they been looking for her? I don't know, maybe they were looking for her and the whole family. I don't really know. Actually, I really want to know. Anyway, what I wanted to say, that if for illegal people in Sweden, the best thing to do is avoid trouble. You know, I am not making this video to encourage people to live here Sweden illegally. No, anyhow, they are here, they are still there, they are still living there. The government know, everybody knows, so it's no longer news. So me doing this video is not like I am trying to encourage illegal immigrants. No, I am just giving people tips because people need help. Okay, so is that number one, mind your own business and stay away from trouble. What do I mean? Don't fight people. I know somebody that fought, a guy that I know that fought recently, and he was arrested, detained, and right now he was deported. All this time he has been living his life the way he live it, surviving the way he knows, because there are other means of a survival. But something happened which led to him, you know, getting aggressive, and unfortunately he was arrested. Remember that you are supposed to go back home. Remember that you've been sent letters by the police that you should go back home. So you don't need trouble. If you still want to live illegally, don't look for trouble, don't go fighting. Another thing, buy your bus card. Your bus ticket is very, very important, because that alone can get you deported unwillingly. You didn't want to, you don't want to go. And I understand many people don't. I mean, I understand the situation, you know. I mean, you must, as a foreigner, you know what people go through and everything. So you really understand why they still stay or they still don't want to go back. So buy your bus card and say parties, avoid parties, avoid clubbing, because it's at the club maybe somebody fight or something happen and the police enter and start, you know, searching ID, and you don't have anything to show, then you are gone. Even some house parties, of course house party are more safer, but if there is a house party and maybe they are making noise, the neighbors report, and maybe something happened, maybe people start fighting and all those things, you know, the best thing you can do is just go to normal gatherings, maybe like church and no guys, sorry, you can still go out and have fun. But be careful of your environment, and also be careful the people you follow. You know, some people are not good, and maybe police have been looking for them, or they are suspects, or their way of life is not good. Anytime anything can happen. So that's another tip. And yeah, I mean, that is the only thing I would say, that just mind your own business and stay away from trouble. So somebody would ask, okay, how do they as immigrants they survive? Because there are some jobs that they do, and also for the children, for people who have children, and that is one good thing about Sweden. The reason, because they already know that we have immigrants here with kids, they already know that the children need to go to school. It will not be fair for the children to stay home while other children are going to school. They'll be like, why is it that we are not going to school? So the Swedish government have made it possible that the law says that every child has the right to go to school from kindergarten to secondary school. So no child is allowed to stay at home. So the law of children going to school covered whether you have documents or not. You have the right to go to school for free. Most of them don't pay, because some of their parents, especially kindergarten, it's not free. You pay if you're working, but if you're not working, of course it's free. So that is why the children go to school and learn as much as they can. Remember, Lelo was going to school. She graduated secondary school all this time. So it's no longer like, it's not like she was there hiding. No, she was living a normal life. Unfortunately for her is that, you know, if they give you a negative decision, you can wait for 4 years. After 4 years, you will now go back and apply again. for her, it was remaining only 10 days, some few days. I think she was even supposed to apply before the National Day on the 5th of June. But unfortunately, when she was at the deportation camp, they had to deport her, because if they had waited until that date, then she would have had the right to apply. Remember, she even had a lawyer that is backing her up and all those things. So yeah, guys, that's what I wanted to say, that stay away from trouble, mind your own business, whatever you are doing, be very careful, always be on the lookout, people you mingle with and people you tell about your information, what you are doing, what you are about to do, where you are about, because some people are not even nice. Some, the same people you trust, they can call police for you, they can implicate you and all those things. So yeah, that is it, guys. That's, I felt like I needed to give an update of what is, you know, it means to be illegal, how people survive and going to school. Okay, how do they go to the hospital? There is a Red Cross, actually, they go. Even Vod Centralen is free, they go. Children go to Vod Centralen, they don't have to pay anything, they just go. Even the big hospital, I mean, children, they don't know anything, so it's their parents that might have problem to go to, you know, to the hospital. But for children, they can go to hospital for checkup, for everything, they will not pay anything, you know. But another thing is, like, I'm talking about those who are here illegally, not the ones that maybe, but there is also some checkups, because I remember one of my friend had a child and she needed to go to the hospital, and they had to the big hospital, and because of the parent, now you see, because the parent have some sort of paper, then they were charged this and that amount. So it all also depends with the situation. You know, in Sweden, if the situation is very critical, they don't even care. They will just attend to you. You know, life, they value life more than anything. But there's also Red Cross. They give clothes, they give food, they give money, because people donate. There's a lot of donation. People donate a lot to help family with a lot of things. So there's also activities going there. Even they have lawyers. I mean, anything that you need, they have it, actually. So yeah, that is how all these illegal immigrants survive here. It's not easy, but now most of them are happy. Not like they are really happy, because they would have wished to get their documents and be in the system, but while it's not working, then they stay here and manage the life they can and try. Some of them are actually saving up some money so that when they get back home, they can start to do like a business or start from somewhere, you know. Just know, you can't just go home like that with nothing. So that is why it's very difficult. And some of them had waited, can you imagine, like 11 years 16 years, and then you go back, you have no savings, you have nothing. Like, it feels very awkward. I think most of them are even waiting for their, at least their children to grow up to a certain level, go to school, so that when they go back home, at least that stage has already, you know, they can focus with other things. Anyway, guys, yeah, that's how I felt like I needed to bring this out, so that for those who don't know how it works, then they would know. And I hope this video help somebody out there. And if you are there and you are living illegally, yeah, don't worry, you are not the only one, there are so many. Anyway, guys, yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, and I see you in my next video. Bye.